the eloquence, the professional way of fighting on a horse. But what was their objective? They were the majority. They had the power behind them. But what was their objective? وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ خَرَجُوا مِنْ دِيَارِهِمْ بَطَرًا وَرِئَاءَ النَّاسِ وَيَصُدُّونَ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ بِمَا يَعْمَلُونَ مُحِيطًا. Do not be like those who came out of their homes boastful, out of boastfulness, to be seen by man, and they hinder men from the correct path. And Allah, wallahi, is encircling, thoroughly comprehending all that which they do. They even had sinners to sing ill of the Muslims. They had dancers to dance at the Muslims' defeat. But what was their flag? What was their flag? Was it La ilaha illallah? No. Their flag was Al-Lat wal-Uzza. It was paganism. It was evil. It was mischief, wickedness. It was filth. It was dirt. It was abomination. It was putrid stench. Their hearts were impure. To be seen by man. That's all they cared about. Because what happened was, Abu Sufyan, who was the leader of the Quraysh, he sent a message to the army, to his army, saying, do not fight. The caravan is safe now. There's no more need to fight. Because the whole reason behind the fight, the war of Badr, was due to a caravan. And we won't go in detail. So when the caravan was safe, he urged the generals and the warlords of Quraysh, of that army, to return back to Mecca, saying there's no need to fight anymore. The caravan is safe. It's going to reach Syria. And then they took it back to Mecca. But the warlords and those people of infidelity, their generals, refused to heed the call of Abu Sufyan. And the arch-infidel himself, the father of ignorance who is, Abu Jahl, he said, we are not going to return until we reach Badr. We spend 3 nights there. We slaughter the camel. We eat, drink wine and liquor. So all the Arabs can hear of us. It's all to be heard and to be seen. That's all they care about. All the Arabs can hear of us and they will continue fearing us forever. Now Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the first battle in Islam. He gathered all his companions and sought their counsel. What should we do? How should we approach this? You know, it's 3-1. Al-Miqdad ibn al-Aswad, this great mujahid, stood up on behalf of al-Muhajirin and said, Ya Rasulullah, O Messenger of Allah, proceed! Look at this great man. Proceed with what Allah has commanded you. Because Allah commanded this battle. Proceed, O Messenger of Allah, with what Allah has commanded you. We are not and we will not be like the children of Israel, who said to Moses, go you and your Lord, you fight and we remain here. Instead, we will fight. We'll fight on your right, on your left, in front of you and on your rear. You know, when he heard this, he naturally got delighted, happy, content. Then Sa'd ibn Mu'av stood up, representing whom? The Ansar. He said, Ya Rasulullah, whatever you command us, we shall obey. Whatever you command us, we shall obey. This is war now. This is fighting. This is sacrificing your life. Reflect. Whatever you command us, O Prophet of Allah, we shall obey. We are not false in the allegiance, in the pledge that we gave you. We are true. We are not scared, he said, to face the enemy tomorrow. We are patient in war. We are firm on the battlefield. Perhaps, he said to him, Allah will show you something in us which will please you. Allahu Akbar. What a beautiful statement. You know, what more does he want from his students? What more does he want? A general when he hears statements, comments as powerful as such, what more can you ask for? You enter the battle already winning, regardless. They're already winners. They love death more than life because they knew death is better for them than living. Four wives is no comparison for 72 wives. Their little home is no comparison to a paradise as wide as the heavens and the earth. The pomegranate, Rumman, is no comparison to a river of honey, of liquor, which does not make you drunk. No comparison. So Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam became stronger, he thought better. And he said, it is as though I am seeing, I am looking at the deathbeds of the people. In other words, it is as though after this statement, I can see the graves of the enemy in front of me, all dead. What a warrior. What a mujahid. What a general. What a lieutenant. What a leader. What a corporal. What a commander. What a man. Allahu Akbar. Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma razikna the ability to see him in paradise, ya Rab. So the two battles met in a fierce battle, in a powerful battle. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam standing, encouraging, enticing his companions, saying, by the one in whose soul hand is my soul, any man that fights today and is killed while patient in the ordeal, seeking the pleasure of Allah Ta'ala and no other, moving forward and not going back, no retreat, will indeed enter paradise. It's a promise from Allah Ta'ala. A promise. And many companions died. They are all from the people of paradise. Every companion that died in the battlefield of Badr, that sought the pleasure of the Almighty Lord, is in paradise. Now, Umayr ibn Hammam said, because Muhammad said to them, a paradise as wide as the heavens and the earth. And we all know, and we've heard many times, the great saying of Umayr ibn Hammam. He said, Ya Rasulullah, a paradise as wide as the heavens and the earth? He said, yes. He said, Bakhin, Bakhin, which is a sign, an indication of strong, firm commitment and acceptance. Because Ya Rasulullah, there is nothing between me and paradise except to be slain by those infidels. He said, yes. So he pulled out dates. Look how they thought. Look how they thought. All he cared when he heard this statement, this enticement, this encouragement from Muhammad of paradise. He goes, what am I doing here? What am I doing here? What am I living for? In the desert? With four wives? With dates? No, I prefer paradise. As wide as the heavens and the earth. So he took out dates, which he had in his pocket. And he said, by Allah, if I were to live for as long as it takes to eat these dates, it will be too long of a life. Allahu Akbar. Yani to live after this statement will be a long life, if I live. What a great man. So he went onto the battlefield. He threw the dates away. He threw the dates away. He ran to a paradise as well as the heavens and earth. He smelled the fragrance of paradise as he's fighting vigorously the enemy until he was slaughtered for the sake of the one who created slaughter. Allahu Akbar. And thus, he will inshaAllah Ta'ala go to paradise. And very easily did they defeat the people of infidelity, the people of idolatry, the people of impurity. 24 of their war lords, their generals, were slain. 24 of their main pillars of Quraysh were slain, were slaughtered. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commanded that all of these warlords be thrown into a well. And thus he even communicated with them saying, do you now see that which you lied? Do you now see